Ah, the dulcet tones of the ZX Spectrum loading. Welcome back to the Retro Asylum YouTube channel, which accompanies the UK's number one retro gaming podcast. But enough of all that, let's take a look at Super Seymour Saves the Planet, which is a 1991 release published by Codemasters and programmed by Big Red Software. Priced at $3.99 when it was first released, the first thing that strikes you about Super Seymour Saves the Planet is that it's a Bomb Jack clone. Sadly, the second thing that strikes you about this game is that it's a bit of a mess. Featuring Seymour, who was a character created to replace Codemasters Dizzy, the fat blob who had previously starred in Seymour Goes to Hollywood now tries his hand as an action hero. Sadly, the background graphics, despite looking quite nice in their own right, make seeing what is going on very tricky. Add to the fact that Seymour himself feels too big to negotiate the way round the platforms, and you can see that the problems are starting to stack up. Sadly, the negatives don't end there. Despite there being a nice AY tune on the main menu and another little ditty as you start the game, there is no in-game music, which it desperately needs. 48k beeper effects might have been acceptable in the early days of the Spectrum, but this game was released in 1991. Most budget games by this point had in-game music on 128k machines. The other negative is the colour clash. Instead of Seymour taking on the colours of the platforms like most Spectrum games, his colours clash over the platforms. Still, at least the game tries to do something different with the Bomb Jack gameplay, in that you are required to kill all of the bad guys before you can move on to the next screen. Even though it was only priced $3.99 when this was first released, I could not have recommended the game back then, and even less so now. The official Bomb Jack conversion on the ZX Spectrum was superb, and I think that you're better off sticking with that.